If you look at the last few games, Harbhajan had it bowled a lot. So it was a case of what Skip felt he wanted to use. We played Hyderabad three times reasonably quickly, and he wanted another option around the right-handers. The fact that Goswami played again was okay at the top. And it was just an option. Again, the captain wanted the leg spin option. It had been discussion all the way through. We had been very open with our spinners around the combinations of not necessarily left hand, right hand, but who could do well. And both Harbhajan and Karan Sharma have got great records in finals and also very good records at Wankhede. So it was just simply a case of gut feel and in this swim with that.
I think the bowlers did a good job. I mean, I had gone here too, and I thought that was a big difficult.
Yeah, I was really happy. I saw Kane say that they were happy with their score, but I was happy because it could have been a lot more. And I think the last two overs from Ngidi and Shardul, which hadn't been a strength, were really important. To only go for 9 each over, 18 runs, and get it under 180, I thought was a good result. I said it was around par score, but that was based on the way that they played. And look, the way that they bowled in the first 4 or 5 overs, it suggested it was going to be a very tough score. But we were able to get some momentum and in the end get there quite easily, which was not a reflection of the game by any means, but a reflection of an innings from Shane Watson. But yes, I was, back to your question, I was pretty comfortable with the way we bowled.
Low qualities that made you go for him when you could have pursued others. And also, did you have to manage his body towards the latter half? How difficult was it? Because he wasn't bowling a lot in the latter half.
Well, our CEO, Mr. Kasi, was very fond of Shane. So whatever he says, I have to do at the auction. He looks quiet. He's got some very strong opinions. And we loved what Shane Watson has done in the past. And our discussion was around his future. And we had seen during the Big Bash that his form had returned, and we also wanted to use him in a different way, opening the batting and possibly bowl a few overs. We've always liked players that are multi-talented. And also, Shane has hurt Chennai a number of times playing for Rajasthan. So we always thought it's better to get him in our side rather than play against him again. And he's been incredibly professional. It even exceeded my expectation how professional he was. He realises he's got some limitations. But he was able to be managed very well and looked after himself, and MS looked after him as well. And in the end, we didn't need his bowling, so he just became a power hitter for us at the top, and no greater illustration than his abilities than yesterday.
This question is for both of you. What is the difference that CSK as a team brings to the tournament, and what has been the importance of someone like a Dhoni to the team?
I think Flem will answer that, because as a team management, he is the one who controls it. And as far as CSK is concerned, all of you know that we've had for the last 8 years what we did. And obviously, it's been a team which has worked as a unit. And I was very confident that even when we come back after 2 years, we will definitely do well. And the credit goes to Flem and MS, who have done a wonderful job.
The other part of it is to have faith put in you from the franchise, and Kasi is being a little bit modest. Our franchise takes us very well. We've been consistent with the players that we've picked, and once we have a core group, we've probably bucked the trend by sticking with players through thick and thin, because we think that gives us an overall chance of success. And even this season as well, we went back to players that we really respected, and the loyalty comes back in droves. And we saw performances from different players throughout the season. So it wasn't just one or two players dominating. It really was a squad effort, and that's something that I'm very proud of as well.
Yeah. Congratulations. How do you felt when CSK were forced to play away from the home ground, and how did this affect psychologically the team members?
Yeah, it was a big moment, and it was in this hotel. We just won a good game, and we were faced with the decision of having to leave Chennai. And when we sat at the auction table, most of our plans were around building a team for Chennai conditions. So it was a difficult situation, but it's out of our control. So we just had to get on with it. Skipper and I had experience at Pune, and that was a deciding factor when we said we'd like to go back there because it's conditions we know there are aspects to playing there that we can get some advantage. But what we had to change was the way we were going to play the game. So we became more seamer dominated, and the strong spinning lineup we had to sit on the side. Imran Tahir and even Harbhajan, the amount of overs and Jadeja, how much they bowled. So it was a big change, and again, it was somewhat out of our control, so you just got to get on with it. And the experience within the side enabled us to do that. So we made the transition pretty well and fathomed a quite strong record at Pune, which is what we were hoping to do here.
Yeah. 6 months back, I mean just a week before the auction when Dhoni was here, he spoke about the team culture, saying players who have done well, who have not done well outside, come here and do well. And similarly, when they do well here, and probably if they picked in the next auction, they don't exactly replicate that form there. He spoke about how the management understands the game, so it is easy for the captain as such to, they know where the team lost or where they won, so he didn't have to explain. How would you view the situation, like in Dhoni's comments, like what's your take, because you are the one who's more involved in dealing with the management side of things?
Yeah, there is the Dhoni impact, and it's very important, Indian players in particular, but it extends to international players, that Dhoni does have a very strong influence and impact on players, and he tends to give players belief. What we try to do as management is give a strong role for the player. So couple that with the MS belief and confidence in a player with a strong role, it tends to work for us. But MS does have a very strong ability to bring the best out of players, and it's our job to wrap that up in a team and provide a bit more of a structure. So it's a great dynamic. There have been a number of players who have, at some stage, as you say, in their career, that have needed a bit of a boost. We see that as an opportunity rather than a favour to the player. So we look at them as, but Riley's a very good example, being in and out of the side to, we think, giving him a consistent role, and he repaid that in bucket loads. And he's just an example of one player, but you could probably say there's double figures that have done that for us. So it's great. It's using the strength of a remarkable captain with a strong franchise with a good game plan. Loves it.
Stephen, from the outside, it has always come across that CSK is one of the most meticulous, plans meticulously. And so just, I mean, probably too early, but like going forward, where do you think this team can improve next year? Where do you think the team can improve, and what are the strong areas that you can maybe further reinforce?
Well, it's hard. We're obviously just coming out of a campaign. I'm not even sure we were the best team in the competition, but we had a really strong desire to do well. I think it's one of the most even IPLs there has been. We talk about meticulous planning. Every other team is meticulous, use of stats. If anything, we use a little bit more cricket feel and gut feel on people. We invest a lot in people by length of contracts and the type of personality. So we're not stats driven, we're people driven. And that's something that will continue, but we're looking to evolve. Next year is going to be even bigger challenge. It's been identified we're an older side. So we've got to make sure that the players that we retain are still professional and can still contribute, but it's 12 months away, so we're still pretty much in the euphoria of winning yesterday, to be honest.
Thank you very much. Our TNPL dropped